I am excited about this opportunity to talk to you about the Wesleyan Covenant Association. I am Angela Pleasance. I serve in the Western North Carolina Conference at South Tryon Community Church. Now, one of the questions you may be wondering is, why did you join the Wesleyan Covenant Association? It was not something that happened overnight for me. It was not something that I woke up one morning and I said, you know what, I am going to join this. It came through a lot of prayer, a lot of discernment, a lot of fasting, a lot of talking to different people, some who have already joined to become a part, and some who are still in the process of praying and discerning themselves. Some of the questions I had about the WCA and the new denomination, of course, being a female, being an ethnic minority female, would I have a place? And I think that was my biggest struggle and my hesitancy. Another hesitancy I had is I am dad's side, a third generation Methodist within this current denomination. I have always been within the United Methodist Church. My mom's side of the family, they were Baptists. But with my dad, I grew up Methodist. My mom became a Methodist and she raised all of us that way. So there were a lot of decisions I had to make personally through prayer, discernment, and my period of fasting. And the conclusion that I came to, first and foremost, is that I am not tied to so much a denomination or an institution, but to the kingdom of God. And one of the ways I describe myself to people that I witness to out in the greater society is I'm a Christian that just so happens to worship in the Methodist Church. And so the other thing that helped me to come to this decision is I began to do my own research. I looked into the Wesleyan Covenant Association. I had wonderful opportunities to talk to Keith Boyette, who was very open and transparent in sharing a lot with me about the new denomination. And what I saw was that not only did I have a place, but any and everyone who desires to make that commitment, we have a place. And so it also came to fruition for me when Keith called me in September of this past year to chair the Global Task Force of Race, Equality, and Equity. And so I had an opportunity with 22 people on this task team globally from around the world, a rich, diverse, and not just by ethnicity, but diversity by different backgrounds and from different churches, large, small, medium, lay people, clergy. And we worked diligently to put together a policy that will ensure that all people have a place. Now, I know what you might be saying. Yes, you can put together a policy, but does that mean it will be lived out? That's a good question. Same question I ask. Because we can put anything down on paper. Jesus Christ is the one that changed the heart. This policy was brought forth through prayer, fasting, discernment. Our whole team prayed together. We agonized over this. We cried over this, and everything within this policy is biblically based. It has a solid foundation in the gospel of Jesus Christ, and it is something that will also permeate every single thing that we do in the Global Methodist Church. So it's not just something that's on paper and then we put it to the side, but every aspect of the Global Methodist Church will live into this, and so that's the joy that I see in that. That's the other thing we talk about. Where do we see God moving? You know, that's the question we often ask in a lot of places. These are just some of the places where I see God moving that, once again, has helped me to make my decision. The other place that I see God moving is I love that a lot of what we will do will be focusing the local church and the mission and the gospel of Jesus Christ. A lot of the monies will stay within the local church so that we can do valuable ministry and mission in our local communities, not to the neglect of going beyond. We would still have, because we are global, so we would still have mission that goes beyond. But I love the fact that lay people Lay, because Methodism is a lay movement. It was very strong in the lay movement. So I am excited that lay people will have a strong leadership within our local churches. They will have voice to this. And so there's just so many ways that I see where not only I have a place, you can have a place, so many people will have a place in the new movement. And I want to close this time, because I can go on and on and on. I'm excited about this. But I want to close this time just by sharing this. It's from one of my favorite gospel songs. But the artist, he says this in the song. He said, "I have an expectation of the supernatural." And that's what I see for the Global Methodist Church. I have an expectation for the supernatural. I have an expectation for a revival breaking out, an expectation for an awakening across our land. And to me, that's what I see within this new denomination. I was reading recently about a program that's being put into place to help revitalize churches, and not just the large churches, but the small and the medium churches and the rural churches. These are the ones that's often forgotten and neglected in the process. And guess what, though? But they make up the majority of our denomination. And so a lot of emphasis will be placed on revitalization and putting skills and tools into the hands of all our churches to help them to succeed as we further the kingdom of God. So, like myself, I hope you take some time to pray, to discern, to fast, to see where God is leading you. I know where He's leading me. It is a personal choice, but I hope you take that time for yourself to determine what is God calling you to do. Have a blessed day.